tic-tac-toe man.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Santa came. Just waiting for the girls. They're teenagers now, so they wash their faces before they get up. Oh, good Lord. It is 7... What time of day is it? Let's see what time of day it is. 7:52. I think I hear the pitter-patter of feet. Hello. It's Kerrigan. What time did you first wake up, Kerrigan?
Which is randomly, I don't know why, and then I went back to sleep at like 5.
Oh.
I don't, like, why did I wake myself
up? And then did I just wake you now, or you were up? Yeah, Bryn Snapchatted me, and I had to respond by turning the light on.
Mm-hmm. But, like, I turned my phone off at, like, 10:30 last night. Like,
oh. So they'll never look in the living room first. They'll never look at their presents. They always go to their stockings first because they want the surprise to continue. Bran! It's a very foggy day out. With all the rain we get, we don't usually get a lot of fog, but it must be freezing out. Let's see if my UPS package ever arrived. They never did send it. Nope. No package. Where my kid at? Look, Kerrigan, Santa ate the ho-hos. You guys forgot to put them out. Santa must have been hungry and found them. Here comes Spring. Here comes Spring. They still don't. They won't look in the room. It's so funny.
Oh, really?
We have a fireplace over top of our fireplace. We have a 60-inch fireplace, as Scott says. All right. See what's in your stockings.
What is it? I can't see.
It's a word search. That's exactly.
Ocean animals.
It's a little bit of therapy for you, Bryn.
It's scary. There's a whale. I was gonna say anything. There's a
you can
there's
trade
a
with the
killer whale.
You can trade with the fur mammals with your sister.
A seal.
Is that everything in your stockings?
Yes.
You wanna go open other gifts?
Yeah.
Wait, I gotta finish my toast.
Oh jeez.
I have to put this back in.
I gotta get my toast.
Bryn!
We didn't get shared.
Daddy!
Wait!
You open your shared gift first or your other stuff?
Wait
for Daddy.
Okay.
Ooh!
Karen,
I got a Hawaiian
lay
bath bomb.
This is so
ooh. Oh, Karen,
this is so pretty!
Excited for a really old
Wii
game.
What's the year on it?
I
don't
know. Nine. Wii Sports Resort.
I'm so hyped.
Is that the one that Matthew has?
Yeah, Macy had this. I'm so excited.
Wait, I've only played it like twice.
I'm so good at fencing.
Yeah. I'm so excited. I know. It's Sharpies. Oh, I love Sharpies. All mine are like dead. I haven't eaten them for long.
I'm bringing those to school.
Ah! Oh my god!
Oh yes.
Two?
I love it.
Now you can play your own records.
Oh.
At the sock hop?
Brilliant.
Duty
all day.
What?
That's so exciting.
exciting. Oh. So it came with a game there.
Where? This one?
No, that Battlefield.
Oh. Oh.
Yes.
Ah. On Wii, you don't get to shoot people.
Yes.
Oh, I'm tired.
I'm a box.
True, true.
Oh, we're opening it together.
Oh. We're opening it together, but I'm
going to
open it.
Call of Duty, rated M for mature. I'm close enough to 17 with that.
FIFA!
Oh! Oh my god. I'm so excited. What's that one?
I don't know yet. I haven't opened it.
Woohoo! Racing! That's like Mario Kart souped up. There's mild lyrics.
Oh my god.
What's this one?
Oh!
Oh, is there remotes?
Oh, just
hit her. I'm sorry. Wireless. Oh, so it comes with one in there.
You get one with the big box.
Thank
you. That's so exciting. That's so exciting. Yes.
Alright, you like everything?
Yes.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Look at it. It's an elephant from IKEA. Look at it. It's so soft.
She carried that around IKEA one
That's
day.
That's what I thought it was. But I just wasn't gonna say.
Oh, it's so cute. It took us so long to find.
So here's our Christmas table. Kerrigan set the table. We have everything ready to go. We each get three Christmas crackers. And then we've got the turkey, who's out on the table, ready, waiting to be carved. We had to cut into him because I don't think he was cooked at the proper temperature. Scott.
Go away from me.
What did you do to the potato? So, because I can't have milk or cheese, Scott.
Show them your slippers.
These are my slippers. My sister gave me those slippers years ago. So, look, here's the potatoes. So, what he did was... What did you do?
I made a mistake, and I can admit it.
And what was the mistake?
I halved the potatoes, but didn't half the cream cheese or the heavy cream or butter. So now I'm over liquefied.
So it was a recipe for how many potatoes?
It was 12 servings. I don't know.
12 servings. So you tried to half it to 6.
Yes, but I only half
the potatoes, but not the cream and the milk and the butter. So the
correct. And I want to apologize for my error.
So we're bringing them out and trying to We were trying to boil some of the extra liquid.
Of you.
It wasn't my fault.
Turkey time.
No. So yes. They're trying to coagulate. And if you see little weird lumps, it's bacon. He's put bacon on everything. There's bacon. Where'd the bacon on the turkey go? You put bacon on the turkey.
Yeah.
Oh, you ate it?
We had a little snack of bacon.
Oh, gross. Okay. And then in the oven. In the oven, we have our green bean casserole, we have our rolls, and we have our dressing. Whose dressing is that, Scott?
Mine.
No, you got it from some lady off the internet.
Aunt Jenny.
Aunt Jenny. We had it at Thanksgiving.
I added my own cranberries.
It was pretty good. Yeah, Scott added cranberries and sunflower seeds too. And celery, or celery is part of it?
Celery is part of it.
Celery is part of it. So, Scott's just having a hard time coping with the fact that he's messed up the meal. The girls are playing Xbox. This was a new thing this year. So we had to get it hooked up. It's over there in the cabinet. And they're playing, what's the game?
Horizon.
Forza. Horizon 3. And we have a couple other games. I think they're in the cabinet. We had to unplug our tree over here. We got Call of Duty, Infinite Warfare.
I think the coagulator one.
Okay. And then they got FIFA, which is a soccer game. And then we got this, which I don't know. We got 12 months of Xbox Live or something. And then then they got Wii games. They got Just Dance 17. And this is a... And then this is an old Wii Sports Resort game that they've played at friends' houses and have always wanted to play. They even had it at the resort in Hawaii this summer, but they never did take a minute to play.
So,
it's very cool, but
are they good?
I get car sick when I play this game.
Can I try it?
Is it off? Oh no. There we go. Bryn's driving a Range Rover. And we've got oh, are the coagulated ones working out? Are they good?
They're good.
Okay.
I know.
So we got everything under the tree over here. So we had a really, really nice Christmas. This was cute, and it gave me a card. It was made by someone at a craft show that she had gone to, and the guy has autism spectrum disorder, and he stamps these cards. His name is Nicholas Overton, and he lives in Brookside, Nova Scotia, and he has a little cardinal on there, and he calls them Nick Notes. How cute is that? Here's my beast over here. Kerrigan's got her water sitting on top of it. This is my Scan and Cut 2. I'm very excited. I'm going to do an unboxing video and figure out how to use it and then share that on my craft channel. But we've had too many electronics going on today. We've had the Xbox and we've had Scott's soundbar. Oh, that was under the TV, or that was on the shelf under the TV. Didn't show you. Bryn got the elephant from Kerrigan. They got One Direction record players and they got records. Bryn has the Beach Boys up on there. And they get some markers and games and stuff. Toys and things. I got a Joann's gift card, which I'm very excited about. So I'm going to use that. And I got some liquid eyeliner from MAC and this Urban Decay eyeshadow palette, which is very pretty. Ooh, nice big mirror. And then some brushes from MAC. They're like makeup brushes. Some socks for work that won't fall down, which I'm excited about. I got two pairs of jammies from Old Navy. I got these red ones with penguins with a red top. And then the ones I had on this morning, they were like long john pants in gray with polar bears on them and a black top. And then a nice infinity scarf in beige, which is really pretty. I got a throw blanket that's back in there. It's like a purpley color. And then a vest. I have my blue vest on all the time, so they got me a black one. And Annette got me this. It's called Nova Scotia Fisherman Extreme Skincare, and it's a whole little pack of skincare, which is really cool. And then Sack Roots. I love Sack Roots. And she got me a journal. There's Miss Kylie in her graduation photo, graduation from high school. But this is a journal, and then she got me a new set of makeup bags. I love these. This is the same brand that makes my little rain boots that I got and my purse that I use every day. So, very cool, and she got the girls each a set of those as well. And I got some, oh god, there goes the turkey carving. I got some red nail polish. And what else is going on here? Bryn got a sweatshirt and some socks. There's her makeup bags right there. They're really cute. They're like a beige with like pastel colors. She got a phone case. Kerrigan was playing with this. She got a flat iron set. So it's the big one and then the little travel one, which is really cute. Those came from Marshall's. They're only like 30 bucks. They're really good. The girls each gave each other toys. They wanted toys for Christmas, so Bryn got the Rapunzel Tower, and then Kerrigan got the Little Mermaid one, and then they got, I think Bryn got the extra little Anna there. Scott got the Peanuts movie. There's a slingshot from Fred Meyer. Kerrigan's been digging in her stuff. There's her One Direction album, and she got the Wicked album. Then she got some games and Sharpies and water bottle. There's her makeup bags from Annette. Hers are like a dark blue, and it says True Love. Really pretty. And she got a light from IKEA. It's like a little light on a, it's like a stand. There it is. I have them in my craft room. And she got the movie Elf, which she loves. And they got some gift cards. She got the little Naked 2 makeup. And she got these pattern socks. They love these. They're from Target. And what's that? Oh, that's her pajama top. And we each got these cords, chargers for our phone. She got a Nike sweatshirt and some slippers. And then her pants, her Avivas, because she doesn't fit into Lulu yet. Here's Scott's hat, and he got some ties, and he got a sweatshirt that he had on earlier, but now he's hot from killing the turkey dinner. So, yeah, so it was a very nice Christmas, and yeah, it was good. Guys, how you doing? Today is Monday, December 26th. It's Boxing Day. How you doing? I hope everyone had a good Christmas yesterday. Today we're just kind of hanging out at the house. Tomorrow I'm going to take the kids shopping. They got a couple gift cards and some money, so they want to go shopping. So today was just kind of a lazy day, although I had to go down to Office Depot a little while ago. I had ordered something online, and I went to pick it up, and it's crazy out there. Costco, you can't even get in the parking lot. Not that I tried, but just driving by. It's madness. So, yeah, so we didn't go out anywhere today, except I had to run down there. And then I started to get on the highway, and I got myself turned around because Big Lots have these Sterilite bins, and I wanted to get some to put our Christmas stuff in. So I went back there and picked some of those up. They're really nice, and they have red bins, so I got those for Christmas. So I bought three before Christmas, and then I bought five more today. So I've got eight kind of medium-sized bins, and then I bought two longer ones. So I have 10 Christmas bins altogether, so I think that should be enough. But I got the longer ones because I have a couple ornaments that are kind of long and they don't fit in the regular bins that I have. So yeah, so that's that was good. I was happy about that. And then I got two bins that were kind of like this color. It's like a pretty greenish blue color. It's more green, I guess. And I got those for Easter decorations. So I think I'm set now for decoration bins. I have red for Christmas, that color for Easter, which I'll just transfer those once I bring out the Easter decorations in the spring. I'll transfer them back into those bins. And then I bought two bins back in the fall that are orange for Thanksgiving, and I bought two purple ones for Halloween because we don't really have a lot of like decorations. Christmas is kind of our main decoration season. So yeah, so I got those today, so I was happy about that. I almost bought one of those containers to keep Christmas wrap in, but then I realized, I was like walking around with it in my cart, and I'm like, wait now. So I went over to their Christmas wrap, and I picked up the size rolls that I buy. I get the really long ones, and they don't fit in the bin. So I was like, yeah, no, I'm not going to do that. So put that back. But I have the one that goes on the back of the door. I have it in our front closet, but we just have like a lot of Christmas wrap, so I'd like to get a specific Christmas wrap one, but yeah, I couldn't find one. I'm not going to take stuff down until second weekend in January, so not this coming weekend. That's like New Year's Eve and stuff, but the weekend
after that, I'm going to take down our Christmas stuff because I know the outside stuff has to be down by a certain date because of the neighborhood we live in. There's like rules and things. You have to have your decorations down. I don't know what happens if you don't take them down in time, but maybe you just get a warning or something. I have no idea. But I don't want to find out. I was originally going to do Christmas shopping in January, but you know what? I'm so done with the Christmas thing, and I knew this was going to happen. It happens every year. But I saw a really neat idea on Pinterest, and I told Scott about it, and he's on board for it. Because it's a good way to save money for Christmas. And I saw this thing that says, buy gift cards throughout the year. Make sure they don't expire. But get gift cards, and then just each paycheck or whatever, get a gift card for like $20 or $50 or whatever. And then you don't have to get it for a specific store, is what Scott was saying. He's like, get a Visa gift card and then put it aside and do that every paycheck leading up to the fall. And then poof, you've got all these gift cards of money that you can use in any store. So I think that's brilliant. I like the idea that he came up with using the Visa gift cards, because then you can use them anywhere. Because I was like, well, what if we put some on Target and we put some on Old Navy and stuff like that? But if you don't know where you're going to end up shopping, it's a good idea. So I think I'm going to do that instead of like trying to actually shop in January, because I think we're all sick of shopping at this point. So I don't know. I just think it might be a good way to try to save up for Christmas, and then God forbid we're like in October and we need to buy something, and we can always just use one of those. But I think it's a neat idea, a neat way to save money. And then it's not just cash, it's actually put on a physical card that you would have to, you know, take to the store or something and be conscious of the fact that you're using it. So I don't know, I think we're going to try that this year. The kids have been enjoying their Xbox. They get an Xbox for Christmas, and it's really fun. We have a soccer game, we have a car game, and we have a very violent war game. It's Call of Duty. And we were playing it last night, and we said to the kids, we're like, okay, do you know this is pretend, and this is very violent, it's rated M for mature, but you know, like, not to go running around with, like an AK-47 or something, and they're like, yeah, it's all good. But it's like crazy because we're used to Wii, and the little knees on the Wii and stuff, but this is like heavy duty, and you've got to like download or upload the games, and it takes a long time, and oh my god, I can't imagine someone getting this like game system for young kids. My god, they'd be so impatient waiting for the thing to load. I'm just working on little items that are going in my subscription boxes. There are still some left, so if you want to check out my Etsy shop, the link is down below. So I'm gonna let you go, and I'm gonna get back to work gluing apparently my eye. Hey guys, it is Tuesday, December 27th, I believe. Okay, this is huge. These pegs go with the shelf in my closet. I have not been able to find these since we moved in over a year ago. Scott just found them. They were in the girls' bathroom on, like, in this little plastic tray, and which just shows you I have yet to organize their bathroom closet for them. And they throw their towels in there, and they've been throwing them on top of this tray. These pegs for my shelf have been in that tray since last November 9th, when we moved in. Unbelievable. I like freaked out just now when he found them. Okay, got my new scarf on. This is my scarf from Old Navy that Scott and the girls got me. And my new vest, I got a black vest. Kids and I are going shopping. And we're just waiting for Kerrigan to finish getting ready. Then we're going to go. And I'm working on the last item for my subscription boxes. I finally figured out how I'm doing something in particular. It's been driving me crazy, and I think I haven't figured out, but now we're leaving. So, yeah. All right, then. So we're going to go. And we're going to go to South Center Mall Kerrigan wants to get some jeans there, and then we're going to go to Bellevue Square, and then I want to swing by Joanne's. That'll be fun. Okay. All right. We're going to go. Okay. Bye. Morning, guys. How you doing? Today is Wednesday, December 28th, is it? I have no idea. Yeah. I have to leave for work in about an hour, so I'm just working on things. I've got little bags of beads. It's for my subscription boxes. Just sold another one this morning. Thank you guys for all the support with these. That's awesome. I have like stuff everywhere, all organized in piles. These are part of the kit. So I'm just bagging up beads to make something in the kit. So yeah. Fun. Everyone's getting a half tablespoon of clear beads. The kids are home. They have big plans for Xbox and Wii today. They said they don't want to play Call of Duty too late in the day because it scares them a little bit. So that's going to be a morning time game for them, apparently. We went to Soap Center Mall, we went to Bellevue Square, and then we went to Joanne's. I bought some ribbon that's going to go in a later box, and I bought an embossing folder for something that's going to be part of a card in a later box as well. So there you go. Oh, I finally found the tall gift wrap holder. So I got one, and it's the same Sterilite thing, but it was the tall one. And I got that, and I got a little, what do they call them? The snap boxes? You know, it's like a box, and then you can snap another one, and then you finally put the lid on it. I had one somewhere. Maybe it's out in the garage. Anyway, I bought a new one to put with the Christmas wrapping and to have, like, scissors and markers and pens and Christmas labels, like the tags to go on presents and stuff, and just have it all in one area because last Christmas, we're like another year away from Christmas again. In the dining room, I had this whole pile of Christmas wrapping and tissue paper and all this stuff, like all on the floor. So now next year I can neatly stand the gift wrap holder and my little bucket, and it'll all look very nice and organized. I want to get organized this year. I say that every year, but I actually want to do it this year. Oops, I still have one more bag to fill. But yeah, I gotta go through the garage and stuff and get rid of things and finally get the little pegs for the pegboard out there and get the tools up on that. Yeah, so that's going to be coming up. It's just like, oh my God, it kills me that I was off for all these years, and I was off for this past year, and I didn't use it to my advantage to get myself organized. I really had no idea that I would send out one resume and get a job. Oh, really don't want to go to work today. Oh God, I like my job, and I'll be fine once I get there, but it's just like, meh. I don't want to go. Someone asked me about YouTube the other week and wondered what I watch on YouTube. Let me bring some up and I'll share with you some of my subscriptions. Because, I don't know, that'll be fun, wouldn't it? No idea. Okay, I like Jennifer McGuire. She's enjoyable. This is her here. Jennifer McGuire, she just did a new video. Hang on, focus. She just did a new video on her craft room. So jealous. Oh my God. Yeah. This is one of my favorite videos. I watch these guys, the Michelacs. They're a young couple and they're in London. They're trying to move from London, but they have the cutest little boy. Look, I'll play this part for you. His name's Grayson. He's adorable. This is Heather. This little British accent. Oh my God, he's adorable. It's a really sweet family. Yeah, they're really cute. At Home with Nikki, she has the most beautiful home. It's everything is like white and silver and taupe and I hit these lamps all the time. Simplified. Oh my god, her style is amazing. Home Organizing by Alejandra. I like watching her. The only thing that drives me crazy is she says hangers, like for coat hanger. Hangers makes me crazy. This is Sari. Love listening to her voice. She is in Sweden. I get those two mixed up all the time. And I adore her. She's so freaking talented. Love her cards. Oh, cross-stitch button. This is Maureen over there in Scotland. Check her out. She does beautiful cross-stitch and she does it like freakishly fast. So you need to check her out. She has a very simplified style. She's a minimalist. And yeah, like unbelievable. I strive to be her. Okay, well, not really. I have too much crap. Christine, I follow. She's the one in Maui. I go on like a binge and I'll watch her like video after video. I let them build up and then I watch them. She does like organizing stuff and makeup stuff. Oh, Teo. This is an artist that I watch. He's in Singapore and he does some beautiful work. You know why? These are my Red Cardinal Craft subscriptions. That's why I'm not finding all my people. Oh, Gus and Snoopy. That's a great channel too. Holly Exley, her and the Michelax, those are my top favorites. She's an illustrator and she lives in, where the heck does she live? Where do you live? I can't remember. She's in England somewhere, but she's just very calm and just very easy to listen to. Araville, she's another one that I listen. Oh, so Holly, I got the deer print. I still don't have a frame for that. And then Araville, I ended up buying one of her prints. She's so freaking talented. Oh my god, her work is absolutely beautiful. Will Terry, I think he lives in Utah, I believe. And he just gives a really good take on illustration and, you know, how to find work and are you good enough and all this kind of stuff. So I love watching him. I ordered a book of his and I ordered it back in October and they've been emailing me and he's like, I'm so sorry, it'll get there. And Xanaro, she is so talented. Let me just show you one of her things. Like it's unbelievable. Like she'll do, books and she'll make a house and the roof comes off and inside it's an album and it's unbelievable. This is a house that, it skipped too fast. I gotta turn it quick. There's a house that she did and then this is all parts of the inside of it. Like, and then that all opens up and she has a very calming voice. Listen to when she comes on. But that's all inside this house, made of paper with lights.
Hello everyone, it's Anna from Anna's Paper Creations and I have a new project.
Anna from Anna's Paper Creations. Oh my god, I adore her. I just noticed that there's a new one from Holly Exley, I believe, so I'm gonna go watch that while I now do the next part of these bags of beads. So all right, I'm gonna go get to work. And thank you to everybody who has been purchasing my subscription boxes. I adore you. Thank you. I'm still trying to get them together, hoping to be a little bit more organized for February's. But yeah, it's hard because it's the first one and I'm trying to figure out what I'm putting in and how many things I'm putting in. So yeah, but I just keep making more stuff, so probably should stop now. But anyway, thank you to everybody, and those will be going out next week. There's still some left, so please check it out. The link to my Etsy shop is below. Shameless plug. I forgot to mention George Michael and Carrie Fisher. What the hell? And Alan Thicke the other week. Like, oh my god, what is happening? yeah, so sad. But it's just weird. Like, you know, you're getting old when people that you grew up listening to and watching are starting to to go away. It's bad. And Carrie Fisher was actually supposed to be coming to Seattle Comic Con in March. Kerrigan and I are going again this year, and I was hoping to meet her. That's the one I was going to do and get like the photo this year. I just thought it'd be really cool to meet Princess Leia. So, yeah, that's sad. I mean, George Michael. I used to roller skate in my garage listening to George Michael. Yeah, so crazy. He was young. I didn't realize he was only 53, but so anyway, give everybody, you know, a hug today just because life's too short and you never know. So there you go. Okay. I'm going to go back to YouTube and crafts. Okay. Bye. Hey guys, how are you? I just got home from work. I just walked in the door and I've got some cards. This one has some red washi tape on the back of it. Oh, this is pretty cute. Oh, some of your little sequins fell off in the mail. It's so pretty. Isn't that cute? It's like a layer of sequins underneath it. Joy, peace, and love. May this Christmas end the present year on a cheerful note and make way for a fresh and bright new year. It's Frankur. I can never say your name properly. But she's in Winnipeg. Isn't that pretty? Look, can you say her name? Frankur, I want to say. Thank you so much. It's a beautiful card. She always puts a little frog. Isn't that cute? Adorable. Thank you. I never did get my thing hanging up in the back there. We've got this one here from Middlefield, Ohio. I believe Borneo. Is this Cheryl? Is this Miss Cheryl? How cute, she put little puff over the oh, that's so cute. She put bubble wrap over his nose. That's a little Rudolph nose. So cute. Hand stamped. My God, did you glue all those down? Seriously? That's a lot of time. Tanya, happy holidays to you and your family. Thank you for continuing to share your time and talents with all of us. Your videos are my favorite to watch, and I'm always amazed by your artistic talents. I hope 2017 brings you much, much happiness. Believe in the magic. Cheryl, yes it is. Oh, there's your... She gave me her call sign on for YouTube. Cool. Thank you. Love it. Adorable. Thank you. Thank you. That's smart, putting the little puff over the, and then look, it got stamped as non-machinable so that it wouldn't go through and break his face. That's smart. Got this one from Lucan, Ontario. Amanda. There we go. Isn't that cute? A little snowman with his shininess on there. Merry Christmas, Tanya, to you and your family. All the best for 2017 from your Canadian friend, Amanda. Cool. And she's put her name, too. That's so cool. That helps me understand who you guys are. Touches of wonder, moments of joy, smiles that come from the heart. Wishing you all good things at the holidays. Very cute. Thank you for that. Then we've got someone down in Lake Havasu City in Arizona. Pretty. We wish you a Merry Christmas. Isn't that cute? It's a green-inspired card. Ooh, printed on FSC certified paper with soy inks. Well, that's fun. And a happy new year and best wishes to you and yours this holiday season. Merry Christmas from Elaine. No, come on, Eileen. I asked her how you say that name, and then she did the come on, Eileen. She doesn't like that song, but I always loved that song growing up. Very cool. Thank you, Eileen. Come on, Eileen. Oh, I swear. This is to the Richards family. Happy holidays. Little snowman going on there from Eric, Phyllis, Tom, and Matt. My Miss Phyllis over there in Boston. Thank you for that. And we've got this one here. I recognize this last name. This is Teresa in Am I? Michigan? God, I'm so bad with that. Oh, it's a little snowman. It's a fuzzy snowman. Merry Christmas, Tanya and family. Happy moments and beautiful memories. That's what you're wished at Christmas time and always. From Teresa. Thank you, Teresa. I'm still trying to... I'm hungry. I need something to eat, so I've got to go eat. So, productive day at work. It was good. Even though I didn't want to go, it was fine. Got stuff done. And, yeah. All right. Thank you for the cards. Okay. I'm going to go. Bye. Hey, guys. How you doing? Today is Friday, December 30th, it must be. I think so. How you doing? I'm just getting ready with the kids to go to the hotel. Scott's at work today. We're going to go into the city, drop our bags at the hotel, and then we're going to go down to Pacific Place, which is a little mall. I constantly hit this. Yeah, I'm just trying to think if there's anything else I'm supposed to bring. A sketchbook. I want my sketchbook. There it is. This sketchbook is like so nice. They sell these at Barnes & Noble. I got this from my friend Katrina in Florida for my birthday in 2009. It's been well used. It's almost full, actually. But yeah, I've got some ideas in there. For my February box, these are taking a long time to do. I just finished my January one. And it's just taken me a long time to kind of get January figured out because I wasn't sure what I was putting in the box totally. And then it's been like just printing stuff and cutting stuff and making stuff. Been loving this. My Christmas present, my scan and cut. I'm going to have a video on my craft channel about that. So that's really cool. They've turned out really good. I'm really happy with them. And I hope those of you that have bought them are going to be happy with them too. And then I gotta get working on February, so I'm gonna sketch some ideas in here. Okay, so we're gonna go to the hotel shop and then go back and go to the pool for a little bit. Then we're gonna get cleaned up. We're gonna go to Shuckers, which is like the fish kind of restaurant. It's like a pub sort of thing. It was an old, how do you say it, haberdashery, where they sold men's ties and hats and stuff like that. That's what it used to be years ago. So, it's now a restaurant called Shuckers and it's very good. I get the fish and chips, but I just peel the batter off the fish cause it's like beer batter. And I'm allergic to beer, so I don't take the chance with the, fish batter cause then I have troubles with my stomach. And then after we eat, we're going to the Little Mermaid at the Fifth Avenue Theater, I believe it's called. Have never seen the inside of it. We've always seen people grouped, outside waiting to go in. So, yeah, so that should be good. And then we're just going to come home tomorrow because Scott's got some football to watch. He's got a couple football games. I'm going to finish packing these up, because I haven't packed them yet. I packed one so far to know how, you know, what they're going to look like. And I have to film the video that has to go with the boxes so that people can make what's in the box. There's going to be a video, like a private video for whoever bought the box, and I got to get the link to it, and I have to film the video in order to get the link to put in the box. So I'm going to work on that tomorrow and hopefully get those all done tomorrow so I can get them out next week. Yeah, we're going to leave here in a few minutes and go, and then I'll videotape. If I see anything in the city, I'll try and get a little quick clip of the theater before Scott yells at me for having my phone out and on. Should I bring this camera? No. I think I'll just film on my phone and there won't be sound because I find with my phone when I have too much video on there, then the sound gets all wonky. So I'll just insert piano music and yeah, there we go. guys, how you doing? Today is Tuesday, January 3rd. How you doing? I hope everyone had a great holiday and had a great Christmas and New Year's. Happy New Year. It's 2017. Whoa. So that's crazy. We didn't do anything for New Year's Eve. We just kind of sat around struggling to stay awake. We just kind of watched TV. That was about it. Around 8 o'clock. Here it was midnight in Halifax, so we called Dad and Annette. Dad had a little party. They had some people over, so that was nice to have it at Dad's this year. And then they did a group photo, and I was in the photo. Dad was holding his phone while we were FaceTiming, so I'm actually in the picture, which was cute. So that was fun. And then that was kind of it. We woke up, we went to bed at, where's my garbage can? We went to bed at like 12:01, and, the next morning I woke up and I looked out the window and there was snow everywhere. It was so pretty. And, so we had a snowy day. It snowed overnight, and, I had no idea we were supposed to get that. So that day, which would have been Sunday, I ended up taking all the Christmas stuff down. I was going to wait until this coming weekend, and Scott was like, just get it over with. So I'm like, okay. So, I did that. And then Monday, Scott helped me put it all out in the garage. And I was so excited to have all my red bins that I got at Big Lots. They were like $4.95 for each bin. And then the bigger bins, I think, were $7.95, I want to say. So I got two of the big bins and I got eight of the smaller bins. So everything fit. So we got everything up top in the garage. The only thing I have left are two red bins that I still have to go through some of the stuff in the garage that I didn't put out this year and just kind of sort. And I don't know if anything needs to be thrown out, but just kind of sort it. But it's like the most organized I've ever been putting my Christmas stuff away. And I'm blanking on your name right now, but someone commented the other day on my Instagram or Facebook and said, at least you don't have to take it out to the garage with the lumber. And I was like, yes, and the rats. So, yeah, it's so nice being in like a proper house where we have space. It's lovely. I still have to organize the garage, and that's on my New Year's resolution list, is to organize my garage. It's kind of a to-do list. But I have my boxes, my January subscription boxes. They went out today. I have 7 left. They're on my floor just because I don't have space in my craft room here. But they're all ready to go. So if anyone's interested, those are still there in my Etsy shop. So check the link down below. I got some cards today. I went to the post office to mail the boxes and I saw that I had some cards. Look at this little card. That's so cute. I was going to show this to Brim, but then I knew she'd want to open it because she loves little things. Let's see who this is from. Oh, it's a Kit Kat in the snow. How cute is that? Oh, cute. 10% of the purchase price is being donated to charity. Oh, that's nice. It's the Marie Curie nurses work day and night at people's homes across the UK, providing hands-on care and vital emotional support. Our hospice offers specialist around-the-clock care, and we support people through their illness by giving practical information, supported from trained volunteers, and being there when someone wants to talk. Oh, that's so nice. And Save the Children is the other one. Save the Children works in more than 120 countries. We save children's lives, we fight for their rights, and we help them fulfill their potential. That's so nice. This little card there. Oh, it's Maureen. Oh, thank you. Best wishes 2017. Thank you so much. That's Cross Stitch Button, if you watch her YouTube channel. And then here's one from Australia. It's Miss Aletta. Well, hello there, Miss Aletta. I'll show you guys where I ended up putting your cards for this Christmas. Oh, isn't that pretty? Wishing you a Christmas filled with joy. Pretty card there. Oh, it's an Australian card. Oh! Oh! Dear Tanya, wishing you and your family a wonderful Christmas and the very best wishes for 2017 from Aletta and family. Look at the little cross-stitch bird. How cute is that? And you know what? I know which bin it's going to go in with the Christmas stuff because I labeled everything. Yes, I did. Because I have a bin called Dining Room. And that's where my trees go, where the ornaments go. Isn't that fun? That's so cute. Thank you. That's adorable. His little pom-pom hat. Thank you, Miss Aletta. Very sweet. And I'll show you where your cards were living. And I found that... Where'd it go? I found that heart thing. So here's my little cardinal bin that I got last year at Michael's after Christmas. It was on sale. And this is where everything goes. And this, see, I have my cross stitch that I'm going to work on. And all my little cards and things. This is what I was talking about. I got this from IKEA years ago. And it has little hearts on it, which is adorable. And you clip your little Christmas cards. And I could not find it. And of course, after Christmas, I found it. It was in with the tree decoration, in the tree decoration box. So what I'm going to do is leave this bin out. And, well, I'll probably put it in my craft closet here, which I have to rearrange. Because, as I mentioned, Scott found the pegs that go with my shelf. See how long they are? They're nice long pegs. But the ones I have currently holding up the shelf are like half that length. So I still don't know how it's holding up. But anyway, so that's going to require a whole day of tearing the closet apart, and I'm really not in the mood for... Oh, I didn't put your little card in here. Little kitty cat got left behind here. Yeah, so I'm really not in the mood to do that. So, yeah, I have to tackle the garage at some point and get the last two Christmas bins up top, where we keep the Christmas stuff, and then I have to organize the garage. And I told Scott it's going to be like a three-weekend process, unfortunately. Ugh. Well, we're off to a good... beginning of the new year, I guess. And hopefully it'll be a good year for all of us. So I'm going to sign off and let you guys finally finish this video. I have no idea what the video was about. I guess Christmas and stuff. I don't know. I haven't done any editing yet. So that's what happens at the end of the video. Now I have to like go back and edit and like kind of create the video you just watched. I hope you guys are good. And I hope you have a good rest of the week. I have no idea when I'm actually posting this video, so maybe you've already had your week. I don't know. Okay, babbling. I'm gonna go. Happy New Year, and I hope you guys are good, and I'll be back with some more videos soon. All right, take care, guys. See ya.